Today's topic is direct killing gold. Okay. Since antiquity, pure gold has been a metal of special interest and practical value. From the dawn of civilization until the present time, man has utilized gold in some form or other in the practice of dentistry. In its pure form, gold has the unusual ability to cohere to itself as room temperature. Gold is quite soft and in a compressible form. Increments can be welded by pressure into a solid metal mass. Another unique feature about gold is its inertness. And under most conditions, it does not tarnish, corrode, or strain. Its chief disadvantages are its color, high thermal conductivity, and technical difficulties in forming a dense restoration. It has one of the highest densities of all elements. Indications: incipient carious lesions, that is class 1 and pits, pit and fissure caries, class 5 caries, class 3 caries. Hello. Class 3 caries, erosions, repair of defective cast margins. Its advantages are no tarnish and corrosion, insoluble in oral cavity, good adaptation to cavity walls, high wear resistance. Disadvantages are color, manipulation, and thermal conductivity. Okay, now we see the types of gold. It is mainly in foil form, that is sheet, that are cohesive, non-cohesive, beads, ropes, then cylinders, laminated foils, and platinized foils. Okay, this is gold form. Electrolytic precipitate, that is matte gold, matte foil, matte gold plus gold foil, and gold calcium alloy. This one. Powdered gold, gold foil, oldest of all products, standard number 4 gold foil, 4 into 4 inch sheets, weight 4 grains, and 0.51 micrometer thickness. Number 3 is weight 3 grains and 3 mm thick. Here we can see that number 4 is 4 into 4 inch sheet and 4 grains weight, and number 3 is 3 grains weight and 3 micrometer thickness. Cohesive, non-cohesive gold. Gold attracts gases, and any adsorbed gas film prevents intimate atomic contact required for gold welding. Manufacturers supply free of surface contaminants, that is inherently cohesive. Cohesive foil. Non-cohesive foil, majority are provided with an absorb protect gas film like ammonia, prevents premature cohesion of sheets that may come into contact. Volatile film is removed by heating to restore the cohesive characters of the foil. Gold foil cylinders. This is another form in which this form of gold is available. That is formed by rolling cut segments of number 4 foils into a desired width. 3.2 mm, 4.8 mm, 6.4 mm using modified number 22 tapestry needle. Perform gold foil. Preform gold foils. There are cylinders and ropes are now available in preformed shapes made from number 4 foil, which has been carbonized or corrugated. Historical interest: Great Chicago Fire of 1871. Platinized gold foil. It is laminated structure, can be produced in one of the two ways. Two sheets of number 4 pure gold foil and a layer of pure platinized foil. Sandwiched between there can be hammered until the thickness of number 4 sheet is obtained. Layers of platinum and gold can be bonded together by cladding process during the rolling operation. Objectives of adding platinum: increases hardness and wear resistance. Electrolytic precipitate, crystalline gold powder formed by electrolytic precipitation. Powder is formed by sintering at an elevated temperature well below the melting point of gold. It causes self-diffusion between particles where they can in contact. Matte gold is a crystalline electrolytically precipitate gold form that is formed into strips, preferred is in building up the internal bulk more easily compacted within and adapted to the retentive portion of the prepared cavity. Disadvantages are because it is loosely packed, it is friable and contains numerous wide spaces. Second is material technique, mat is covered with a veneer of foil. Mat foil, sandwich of electrolytic precipitate, gold powder between sheets of number 3 gold foil. Purpose is try to eliminate the need to veneer the restoration with a layer of foil no longer marketed. Alloyed electrolytic precipitate, the newest forms of electrolytic precipitate, electroalloy, ARV, is alloyed with calcium. Calcium content of the finished product is about 1%. Purpose is to produce stronger restoration by dispersion and strengthening. Powdered gold, first used in early 1960s. Gold powder was enclosed in number 3 gold foil. Maximum particle size is 74 micrometer and average is 15 micrometer. The atomized and chemically precipitated powders are first mixed with a soft wax to form pellets. These wax gold pellets wrapped with foil. Removal of surface impurities. With the exception of non-cohesive gold, the direct curing golds are received by the dentist in a cohesive condition. During storage and packaging, they are exposed to the atmosphere. It is necessary to heat the foil or pellet before it is carried into the prepared cavity. It is called annealing, heat treatment, degassing. A more appropriate term is desorption. It is essential to achieve a cohesive mass. Chemosis fingertips should be worn by the dentist to protect the gold from contamination. Proper desorption is a matter of heating long enough at a temperature that removes gases and, in case of powdered gold, burns away the wax. Temperatures in the range of 600 to 1300 degree Fahrenheit must be produced. Under heating should be avoided because it does not adequately remove the impurities. Overheating should be avoided because excessive sintering causes the material to become more stiffer, less ductile and difficult to condense. Too long time, too high temperature, temperatures below 315 degrees Celsius are inadequate. Okay, this is also one of the most important thing to know about the gold, that is annealing or degassing. It can be done by flame heating, flame annealing held near the top of the film, and the surface impurities are dissolved or surface impurities go off. The alcohol flame is transparent. The flame from the pellets is visible. Pellets are being heated on a tray. Okay, this is the electric annealing at a particular temperature. This electric annealing is carried out. When heating in bulk on a tray, excessive amount should be avoided since the difficulties arising from prolonged heating can arise from repeated heating as well. Handle the pieces with stainless steel wire points that will not contaminate the gold. Flame desorption occurs when the gold segments has exhibited a dull red glow. The fuel may be alcohol or gas, but alcohol is preferred because there is less danger of contamination. Alcohol must be pure methanol or ethanol without colorants or additives. Advantages of flame desorption: ability to select a piece of appropriate size, desorption of only these pieces used, less exposure to contamination, less danger of over-sintering. Disadvantages of electric annealing: pellets may stick together if the tray is moved. Air currents may affect the uniformity of heating. Difficult to anneal appropriate amounts of gold. Over-sintering: greater exposure to contamination. Size selection among the piece of dissolved gold is limited. Compaction of direct filling gold: condensation is the procedure used to condense and harden the gold inside the cavity. Preparation: two main processes are welding and wedging. These are the procedures, welding and wedging, for compaction of or condensation of the gold in the cavity. Welding is forming atomic bonds between pellets or layer as a result of condensation. Wedging refers to the pressurized adaptation of the gold from within the space between the tooth structure walls that have been slightly deformed elastically. Straight points are kept in the prepared cavity and the first piece of the foil are wedged into these areas. It can be done by hand millet, pneumatic vibrator condensers and electrically driven condensers. These are the different condensers. First one, A1 is nichrome wire used for carrying gold. B is pneumatic condenser. And C, detachable condensing pins or the various shapes condensers. Physical properties of compacted gold. Strength and hardness is BHN of pure gold is 25. During condensation, its hardness rises to 75 tensile strength, rises from 19,000 psi to 30,000 psi. Yield strength rises from 0 to 30,000 psi. Density. Density of pure gold is 19.3. Density of well compacted direct gold is 16.5 cm cube. The difference is due to the presence of porosity and voids. Melting point of gold is 1063 degrees Celsius. Tarnish and corrosion resistance is good. There is very little margin leakage between the filling and cavity walls. If the compaction is good, it dissolves in aqua regia. High thermal conductivity. Biocompatibility, it is biocompatible, produces only a minimal pulpal response. If compacted properly, the technique, however, involves a certain amount of trauma to the tooth and its supporting tissues. Okay, thank you. Here, just remember the classification of gold, uses, advantages, disadvantages, and most important part is annealing or degassing of the gold or clearing the impurities from the gold. And last one is compaction of the gold. Thank you.